Hey everyone, and welcome to day three of the ISSF World Cup final in Bologna for 2016. It's the season closer. We're about to commence with the first of four finals today, the women's air rifle. Daniel Potts, our announcer, just introducing the athletes. Ilahe Ahmadi is first on the range. She made one final this year. That was at the Olympic Games, where she finished sixth as she's defending her World Cup final title from 2015. She is the current European champion. She did win gold at the ISSF World Cup in Munich, but surprisingly didn't make the Olympic final in Rio. Yi Ling is an incredible shooter. She's still the finals world record holder, and her eighth World Cup gold came at Bangkok in the season opener this year. It's a great year for the Russian shooter, whose silver at the World Cup test event in Rio was her first ISSF medal. Yes, the 19-year-old shot to stardom after becoming the first Olympic champion on the continent of South America. On 5.F, representing the People's Republic of China, World Cup silver medalist in Beijing 2 years ago, and World Cup gold medalist in Baku this year, Du Bei. She qualified first for this final today, and her gold at the World Cup in Baku was her first ISSF World Cup gold medal. The talented 24-year-old made two finals this year. Silver in Bangkok is her brightest career medal yet. And finally on 5.H, representing the People's Republic of China, Olympic champion in Athens, Olympic silver medalist in Rio, four times World Cup final title holder, and six times World Cup gold medalist, Du Yi. The third Chinese athlete in the final today brings a wealth of experience and a stunning CV, which includes gold at the World Cup in Rio and then silver in the same venue for the Rio 2016 Olympic Games. The gathered crowd here today just being introduced to the officials. And there's the chief range officer. And next to him, you can see the announcer, Daniel Potts, as well. Well, thank you very much for joining us today to tune in for the final. My name is Shaq, and it's a delight to be joined by one of the best, loveliest shooters in the world, Snežana Pejčić from Croatia. Snežana, lovely to see you today.
Hi, Shaq, likewise, and thanks for inviting me.
An absolute pleasure. Thanks a lot for giving us your time in what must be... It's a kind of a relaxed vibe that we've got here at the World Cup final, but still busy for you. You've got a bit of training going on a little bit later today.
Yeah, it's an interesting competition, you know, it's much more laid back than the usual World Cups, and yeah, I have a pre-event training to 2:30 today, so I have time for you.
We should, we thank you for your time again. We should mention that the World Cup final is a kind of a unique event. It's the season closer. There's quite a relaxed, laid-back vibe. You can feel it around the range. You can feel it with the shooters as well. And the way that the athletes are qualified for the World Cup final is on a points-based system. And these points are accumulated from various World Cup standing positions throughout the year in the World Cups. If athletes win medals, they mm-hmm. win points. And sometimes the actual scores in the competition can also contribute to the point system. That's the basic overview. But like with anything in ISSF rules, pretty complicated if you go quite deep into it.
Exactly. It's not really easy to explain. Sometimes it's enough to be in the final. Sometimes it's not even enough if you win a medal. So yeah. It depends.
On a basic level, you'd really say that in each event, there's about 12 athletes who will participate. And they are pretty much the 12 best performing athletes in that discipline throughout the season.
Yeah, usually it's I think 9, but in a year of World Cup, World Championships and the Olympic year, there are 12.
Well, the competition is underway and Arsovic of Serbia storms straight in with a 10.8, a brilliant first shot from her. Five of the athletes have shot at the moment. Du of China. Actually, there are two athletes called Du on the range. This is going to be hard to keep hold of, but Du Bei and Du Yi are the two athletes with that name on the range. It was Du Yi who shot a 10.7. Arsovic followed up a 10.8 with a 10.5. Ahmadi, her second shot, a 10.5. Really strong start to the competition so far.
Yeah, amazing. And classical air rifle.
It's Du Yi who is top of the leaderboard at the moment, but she has only shot once so far. It's twice now. 10.3 was her second shot. Now, I noticed this in every competition. Arsovic has shot three times now. She's always really quick on the trigger.
She's one of the fastest shooter ever that I've seen. It's also in the qualification. She's, if not the first, then in the first three that finished the match.
And why do you think she's chosen that as her particular technique?
I guess it works for her. I mean, apparently.
It does.
Works, yeah.
She's she's top of the competition at the moment. We just mentioned that she's on 31.9.
Amazing.
She was the first to hit all three targets, 10.8, 10.5 and a 10.6. Ilahe Ahmadi, the Iranian, excellent shooting from her. She's only 0.1 behind Arsovic at the moment. Two 10.7s.
Those are some really great scores.
Really strong.
For the beginning.
We're just looking at Du Yi at the moment, and she shot a 9.7 with her third shot. That was only one of two nines that were shot in that particular series. That was one of them. Hoffmann of Austria also shot a 9.9 with her second shot. Currently in joint sixth place, those two athletes. And the current Olympic champion is perhaps surprisingly started a little bit slowly in the competition. She's bottom of the scoreboard at the moment, Virginia Thrasher, with a score of 30.2. But a good standard because all of them shot over 30 here.
Absolutely.
To start the competition.
And, you know, it's still early, especially in air rifle. It's not over until, well, how they say, the fat lady sings. So they have plenty way to go.
We're just looking at the current leader, Arsovic, a beautiful purple rifle. I mentioned this before, but I love the appearance of her rifle. And you might have just have noticed that she's got her name inscribed on it as well. First to shoot again, a 10.3. Consistent. Ahmadi with a 10.4.
It looks so easy when the other girls are shooting.
And this relates to the pressure that you talk about of being in a final yourself.
Yeah, it's... at least I can speak only for myself, but no matter the amount of finals that I've been in, it's always hard to perform when you get there.
And the various elements that contribute to that, is it the crowd, is it the music that plays, is it your own thoughts?
Well, not music, not the crowd, it's just the fact that you are in the finals and now you have to fight for the medals. And you know, now it's what counts, so stressful.
Ahmadi shot a 9.7 with her second shot. She still holds on to second place, though. We're just looking at Virginia Thrasher right now. Visibly trying to calm herself. The strongest shot of this series so far has been a 10.5. From Arsovic, Vidovina of Russia, and also Thrasher, who shot really well with her fifth shot. That was the 10.5 and her highest of the competition so far. It's still the Serbian who's leading, though. This really is a great standard. Arsovic has hit the 10 ring six times with all six shots so far. Her second series, just slightly lower than her first, 30.9, 1 point lower than her first series. Virginia Thrasher, this is a great comeback from her.
Yep.
She was in eighth place. She's now in joint sixth place. You can see that she shot a 10.5, followed by a 10.8. Yeah, and she's now in joint fifth.
Sometimes you need just one shot to pick you up a little bit.
The cliche is that one shot can change everything, but it really is true.
Yeah.
Well, 30.9 was the highest score of that series, and three athletes shot that score. That was Arsevich, Vidovina of Russia, and Yitze Ling of China, all shot a 30.9. I beg your pardon, the highest score was actually Virginia Thrasher. It was a 31.6, so that really was a brilliant comeback from her, and she's now in joint fifth place with the Chinese athlete Yitze Ling. And this is a really good competition so far for Elahe Ahmadi. She hasn't made any World Cup finals this year. She did finish sixth at the Olympic Games, but she is trying to defend her World Cup final title that she won a year ago in Munich. And she's looking good for that at the moment.
Yeah, she's a really amazing shooter. And, well, if you ask me, I think, aside from men's prone, it's the hardest discipline to enter the finals at the World Cups is air rifle, women and men.
And why would you say that?
Well, we are also close, you know, and with the decimal scoring, it's, well, a high results and everything.
Arsevich once again, first to shoot, 10.6, solid. These are single shots now. We're on the seventh shot at the moment. A 10.9 from Elahe Ahmadi, brilliant shooting. That might not be enough for her to take first position, but I believe she'll only be 0.1 behind Arsevich now.
Yes.
Yeah, and that is the difference.
It's important to stay close, not to leave the big gap between the shooters.
So yeah, it is a 0.1 difference between Arsevich and Ahmadi now. The next shot will confirm the first elimination, and Olivia Hoffmann is 0.9, or is that 1.1? My maths is terrible.
1.1.
It's a 1.1.
And I suck at math.
It's a 1.1 between Hoffmann and Dubei of China. It looks like quite a healthy lead for the Chinese athlete who's currently safe, but, you know, anything can happen and it's possible
over,
to overturn.
Yeah. It's seven shots only, so I think we all saw things happening when you at least expect them, so.
Here she is, Olivia Hoffmann. And you know, she'll definitely, whatever happens today, she'll definitely look back on the year as a success. Before this year,
absolutely,
she'd never even entered a final, and she's had some incredible success.
Yeah, it was a good season for her, and I think she should be satisfied with it.
Actually, I do correct myself. She did enter finals in 2015, but her rise in the last year and a half has been great, and she did win a silver in this discipline at the season opener in Bangkok. Ahmadi shot a 9.5 after her 10.9, so she might slip down the table a little bit. Arsevich with a 10.6, so she's going to increase the gap, and a couple of 10.7s from two of the Chinese athletes as well. But it is going to be Olivia Hoffmann then who takes eighth place in the final. She looks visibly a little bit disappointed with that. But I think when she, as we say, when she does reflect on her season, she'll be happy with the success and impression she's made.
Yeah, it's normal to be disappointed right after the shooting. It's, you know, when you're shooting, it doesn't matter how good season or bad season you had. You're just shooting this match right now.
Yeah, she does look disappointed, but high standards, a few nines in her shooting let her down there.
Yeah.
And Snezhina, we talk about you and in the three positions which you really are specializing in at the moment. Wow. You've had an incredible World Cup season. I mean, I can't remember the last time we were in this situation where you entered four World Cups and you won three gold and one silver. In Rio, you set a new qualification world record of 5.94 out of 600. An extraordinary World Cup year. I'll just take a break
yes.
to tell you that Arsevich shot a 10.9 and Ahmadi with an 8.9. Her last couple of shots have been really disappointing. Yeah.
I'm afraid it's going to cost her.
It might do, because Ahmadi has now slipped to fourth place. But you have had an extraordinary World Cup year, and I think it's fair to say the expectation was high on you at the Olympic Games in the three positions discipline. And how will you look back on your season?
Well, you know, Michael McPhail said 2 days ago that it was bittersweet, and he couldn't describe it more accurately. It was the best season so far, but then at the end, you know, it's the Olympic year, and I can't say that only that matters are the Olympics, but it's the biggest competition of the year, so it was kind of disappointment, but also really good World Cup season, so yeah. I don't know what to tell you, actually.
Right, no, that's completely understandable. It's a strange one with the Olympic Games, because it's a global event, it's our chance in shooting sport to really promote what we have and expand our profile as much as we can, so there's a lot of expectation on it, a lot more people are watching, so of course it means more to everyone.
Exactly.
But you can't consider, well, it's hard to say, a disappointment because you weren't in the final, but you just look at the achievements that you accumulated during the ISSF World Cups and they're unmatched, quite frankly.
Yeah, but still, you know, it's all the competitions on one hand, and on the other you have the Olympic Games, and it's the way it is. It's the biggest competition. But to tell you the truth, the pressure was just too much. Mm. It's, you know, fair to say I couldn't take it.
A mixture of emotions, but certainly an amazing year, as we say, at the World Cups. Just performance after performance was great to watch you, Snezhina.
Thank you.
Arsovic comes in with a 10.4. Ahmadi taking quite a while to take her shot. She's not so fast here.
Yeah,
she's actually in seventh position at the moment.
Yeah.
And this is going to be an elimination shot.
Yes, I'm afraid it's...
A 10.3 is good, but not quite enough. She smiles to herself because she did make the final. As you said, Snezhina, the standard was very high, and she was shooting amazingly until two shots let her down. But it just goes to prove how quickly things can change, because she slipped from second, 0.1 off the leader, to seventh, and she's now eliminated. So there will be a new World Cup final gold medalist today. She won't be able to defend her title, but it's good to see her back on the range as
Absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely. She's a great shooter, really an amazing girl.
And very humble.
Yes, yes.
And a nice spirit in the Iranian team as well. Really friendly guys.
Like we saw, it's enough for have 1 second slip of concentration and you're out. It's shooting.
It's shooting. The Iranian presence here is Ilahe Ahmadi, and she's also got her teammate Mahalaga Jambozog, who's going to be competing with Snezhina in the three positions final tomorrow. Arsovic is leading the competition by 1.3 now. Her nearest rivals are Vidovina and Itza Ling, who have exactly the same score. And wow, because Arsovic just shot a 10.8.
She's shooting like, well, I don't know, amazing.
I honestly can't tell you. I've seen Arsovic in a lot of finals. I've been privileged to announce her quite a few times, and I can't remember her shooting a bad final. She is a finals girl.
Yes. Yeah, she's a shark.
A shark.
Yeah.
A shark, that's a good one. Virginia Thrasher has shot a 10.6. She's currently in sixth place, only 0.1 off her nearest rival, although she's now in joint fourth.
She's climbing, slowly but steady.
Her competition has improved. Well, Arsovic is now leading the competition by 1.7.
That's a lot.
It took me a while to figure that out.
Okay, you're getting there, you're getting there.
I got it right the first time, so she's leading by 1.7 now. And I believe I'm right in saying that she hasn't hit the nine ring yet. So again, you can just tell how high the standard is.
Yeah, and her tens are amazing. And I think first 10 shots were 105.4, if I'm not mistaken. It's just, wow. I would take that any day.
It's great shooting. And I'll tell you something about Arasovic. She's had some really memorable finals in the last couple of years. When she won gold at the European Games, her celebration, her reaction is amazing. I love watching that, and I'm sure it's great for the spectators as
well. There is a bunch of emotion there, yeah.
There's a lot of passion in there. It's brilliant. 10.7. 10.9, 10.4, 10.8, 10.7. She really is walking away with this final at the moment. Thrasher with a 10.6, which is really good shooting. She's currently in joint fourth.
She'll be on third, I think.
That's Dube with a 10.7. It's a shoot-off.
Yes.
And two Chinese athletes will shoot off for their position. Well, look at this. Just at the top of the leaderboard, we mentioned that Thrasher has now elevated herself into second position. So she really has come on strongly. But it's going to be Du Bei and Yitze Ling who are going to shoot off to stay in the competition. But three Chinese in the final isn't bad.
Yeah.
It's a nice, clean indoor range, this as well. Once again, we mentioned that the finals are actually happening inside the qualification ranges. We're calling today Air Day.
Yeah,
I just made that up because we got
air day.
Four air finals, one after the other. Both air rifle followed by both air pistol. Yitze Ling with a 10.5 in the shoot-off. Du Bei is still to shoot. She's taking her time.
That's a long game.
She's really taking her time here. Well, she's only got 50 seconds, and I haven't been counting. She just shot, and it's a 9.9. So it is going to be Du Bei who is eliminated from the final. She will take sixth place. It was very close. But we do emphasize that is a great Chinese presence in the final. So I think overall the coach will be happy as well.
Yes. All the qualification girls came into the finals.
And Du Bei did win her first World Cup gold medal this year. That was a gold at the last World Cup in Baku.
It's amazing how Chinese have such a great amount of good shooters.
It is amazing.
They came at the World Cup for the first time. They win a gold.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
You know, there was a situation in Munich where the 19... I won't forget this. The 19-year-old...
I remember.
The 19-year-old Chinese shooter had never entered an international competition before. Not only did he win gold, he set a new finals world record.
Yes.
It was incredible.
You know, for us who are a bit older than that, it's kind of, I don't know, not nice.
Yeah.
Respect your elders.
Yeah, right. But, we talk about this in every final, but, to get some more insight into the Chinese technique and how they train would just be fascinating because they're always shooting very strongly in World Cup events. And unfortunately, there's not such a high level of English that they speak. There are a couple, but not shooters themselves. Mm-hmm. So it's a little bit difficult to communicate with them and really find out their secrets.
Yeah.
Well, Du Yi with a 9.3, and you heard a little reaction from the crowd there. Arasovic shot a 10.5, but Yitze Ling, 10.8, and she jumps over Virginia Thrasher into second position now. But it is still Arasovic who's leading, and she's not giving up here because she's leading the final by 2.1 now.
That's, I think, more than enough for her.
She's looking very good to win gold here.
She always looks so confident when she's shooting.
She does. She does. And again, we have to say that it was... it really, you would consider it as a shooting sport fan, shock that she didn't make the final in this event in Rio, because not only didn't she make the final, that she finished 26, which it's not something you can really explain, but...
You can. Two words. Olympic Games. It's different, like I said.
And there we have an explanation. Well,
you're welcome.
The pressure really is immense. Well, that's a 9.7, her first nine of the competition. She has been shooting strongly enough that it shouldn't make too much of a difference.
It won't.
Thrasher shot a 10.6, and I beg your pardon, a 10.7, and Ita Ling with a 10.6. And Thrasher and Ita Ling are now in joint second position, but it is Arsovic, the Serbian, who's still leading by a 1.2. Well, Dui is the next elimination.
I think she's the most consistent Chinese shooter that I've seen her for such a long time.
She has an incredible CV. It would take us the rest of this final to read it all out. But she does have 6 World Cup gold medals, and her last one came at the World Cup in Rio this year. That was her 6, and she's just eliminated in 5th place. She also has 4 World Cup gold medals in her career, and she was the Olympic champion in Athens as well. An incredible CV.
She's really amazing.
You can just get a sense of the spectators in the background there, gathered just behind the shooters. A really intimate feel that we were saying earlier as well.
Yeah, everything is kind of cozy.
Cozy is a nice word, especially as it's indoors today.
Yeah.
Arsovic comes back from a 9.7 with a solid 10.3. A 10.8 from Ita Ling, so she's starting to really put the pressure on Arsovic as well. That is a brilliant shot. Vidovina also with a 10.8. This is so close between the remaining 4 athletes.
Yeah.
Arsovic is leading now by 0.7. It was a 2.1 about 3 shots ago, but Ita Ling is putting on the pressure.
So close now.
There's a 1.1 difference between Ita Ling and Virginia Thrasher in 3rd place as well. And there's only a 0.3 for Vidovina of Russia to push into one of the medal places, and the next shot is going to determine that. For the next competition shot, load. Here is Virginia Thrasher. What a great year for her as well.
Amazing.
19 years old. And let's not forget that not only has she not won a gold medal before becoming Olympic champion, she had never won a medal.
Yeah.
And that was her first ever medal. She'll remember
nice
that.
Nice way to break the ice.
For sure. Hello, everyone.
Yes. Hi, it's me. Nice to meet you.
A 10.5 from Thrasher. Is it going to be enough? A 10.6. Yes. It is going to be enough.
Yep.
Vidovina, very good shooting. A 10.6. Well, so it's the Russian who will take 4th place. And again, a really good year for her because she won her first ISSF World Cup medal this year. That came at the test event in Rio where she won silver.
And she's such a constant in the finals.
She is.
Even you on small bore or air, it's really, she's always there.
It's been a really good year for her. She did actually make the final in this event in the Olympic Games as well, where she finished 5th. So
she's a good shooter, yeah.
Really good progression for her. Well, Arsovic, E, and Thrasher are now guaranteed the medals. Will there be some more twists? It's a 0.8 difference between Arsovic and E, and a 1.2 difference between E and Thrasher. But Thrasher really is on form. Let's not forget also that she is still studying at university, and fair to say she's one of the most popular girls in her uni at the moment.
I would say so, yeah.
A 10.6 from Arsovic, that's excellent. 9.5 from Thrasher, and a 9.9 from E. So that really works in the Serbian's favour, because she's now leading by a 1.5. Well, Thrasher still has a chance to go above a bronze here, but it's going to be difficult.
Really hard. But we saw, you never know.
It's a 1.6. I'm a little bit of a nerd for statistics, and I remember numbers really well. But what I do remember is that at the World Cup final 2 years ago in the 3 positions, you, Snezhina, overturned a 1.8 over Petra with the last shot to win gold.
Yeah.
So
Yeah, everything can happen.
It can happen. It's the 18th shot, and this would decide the bronze medalist. Arasovic first again with a 10.8. She's really coming back into form. If she keeps this up, she will run away with the gold. It's going to be Thrasher who takes the bronze medal then. A 10 even to finish. A great year for her. She's a lovely, friendly girl. She's always got time to talk to people, whether you're a spectator, a coach, a fellow athlete, or just a fan. She's a really, really good girl and a beautiful role model for the sport as well. 19-year-old Olympic champion Virginia Thrasher takes bronze medal in this competition. Well, Arsovic has now increased the lead over Eterling back to a 2.1, so she's really in a commanding position for these last two shots.
And it's going to be a really amazing score of the finals.
Well, the finals world record is...
A lot.
off the a lot, it's fair to say. It is 2.11. 2.11. I'm not sure if she'll quite be able to reach that, but it will be a really
high
score.
But it's going to be high, yeah.
That 2.11, by the way, was in fact shot by Yi Zeling at the Beijing World Cup 2 years ago. Arsovic shoots a 10.5. She's pretty certain for this gold medal here with one shot to go. Yi Zeling hasn't shot yet, but here she is. Another incredible shooter. What a CV she's got as well. Yeah. 10.6, it's better, but Arsovic does lead going into the last shot by 2 points.
And I have to say this about Yi Zeling. It's always, she looks so happy all the time.
She does.
She's shooting and she looks like she's smiling. And it's so nice to see, you know, with all of us feeling so, trying to concentrate and focus and everything. I don't know who told me I look really pissed when I'm shooting, but I'm only trying to concentrate. And she's smiling. And it's so nice.
We understand the emotion. We do apologize for any viewers who were offended by that particular word. But
yes, I'm sorry.
Yeah. But no, we completely understand. Actually, we have referred to you in finals as when we introduce you having a game face. You're right there in the zone. And it is interesting to see the different reactions that we see from the shooters. It's the last shot. And Arsovic is, it's a 9.1, but it's still going to
be
enough. It's going to be enough. Sure. It's going to be enough. She's relieved as well. Oh, a 10.8. Well, that was a way to finish. But Arsovic is really lucky.
Wow.
She's relieved. Look at how she's breathing here. Well, she's going to be really happy with that. She would have hated to have given that up on the last shot. But
you know,
2 points.
That would be a waste.
2 points was enough. She finishes on 2.09 as a total score. Yi Zeling, as you said, looks really happy. But, that was a fortunate end for her. A 9.1 was a way to finish. But she is the new World Cup final gold medalist. A fantastic shooter. And she ends a good year really, really well. So Daniel, just introducing the medalist to us once again. Virginia Thrasher takes a bronze medal in the World Cup final. Yi Zeling, 27 years old, the current world number 3, still the finals world record holder. That's her second silver medal in a World Cup final. And Andrea Arsovic wins the gold medal. And in fact, that is the first time she's won a gold medal in this discipline at the World Cup final. She has had a really good year. She also won gold in Munich at the World Cup in May as well. So that's how she finishes. A nice season for her.
Not bad. Not bad way to end it.
So congratulations to them. And thank you very much for joining us. There's no stopping now, though, because we're going straight into the next 3 finals back to back. The men's air rifle final will follow shortly. And Snezhina, an absolute pleasure to see you, to speak to you as always, to get your insight, and really congratulations on a wonderful ISSF World Cup year. Extraordinary achievements.
Thank you
and
so much.
Best of luck for tomorrow, where you shoot 3
Thank
positions.
You.
Just tell us where we can find you on Instagram, because you've got a bit of a social media presence, so any one of your fans who want to follow you, they can follow you at
Sneki137.
Sneki137. You can follow Snezhina herself, and you can follow the ISSF. We're all over social media as well. You can find us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share, and promote shooting sport in what has been an amazing year for us all. Thank you very much, and we'll see you for the next final.
The bronze medal representing the United States of America goes to Virginia Thrasher! Representing the People's Republic of China goes to Yi Xilin. Position will receive 500 euros in addition to the medals and the trophies. So once again,